And following Olympic order, the home team always begins a meet on the vault. And here we find Georgia's Lauren Sessler.
Lauren's going to start off for the Gym Dogs with a big Yurchenko Arabian. You see on the landing, she had a little bit of a stiff leg landing, which caused her to bounce forward and take that step. So that's going to be a deduction on this vault, as we show you again.
A 9-8 for Lauren Sessler. And we should mention, you will notice both teams wearing pink tonight, including Utah's Nina Kim.
Nina starts off her bar routine with a toe shoot handstand to an immediate overshoot and an uphill. That will be a big combination move for her. Her second handstand is all the way up, followed by a reverse hecht. Last handstand also done nicely. She winds up for her dismount, two giants to a full out and a stuck landing. So a great bar routine for the Utes to start off.
And the pink, of course, is in honor of those battling breast cancer.
And both teams tonight are wearing it, and the money that's raised for each 9-9 that the girls scored goes towards the American Breast Cancer Foundation.
Here is Cassidy McComb.
Cassidy does a Yurchenko full and a very small step, or hop, excuse me, backwards, but we saw her last week do that vault land with her chest a little bit low, so it's good to see her to actually get the height off the horse this week and come up with a little bit bigger of a score.
Another 9-8 for the Gym Dogs. Here we find Jamie Dietzkrieg.
Jamie starts off with a toe shoot Shaposhnikova to the high bar, overshoot handstand to an uphill, again one of those combination moves. Her second handstand looks to be a little bit short. She does a giant full to a reverse hecht. Now she'll get ready for her dismount. A double layout and another stuck landing for Utah. So they're really kind of answering back Georgia. Each vault that Georgia gets, you know, Utah's putting up some pretty decent scores on bars.
I have a feeling we'll be back and forth given the caliber and talent of both these teams. A 9-8-7-5 for Jamie Dietzkrieg. Back over to vault, the powerhouse from Georgia, Marcia Newby.
Marcia will do your Yurchenko Arabian and a very small step to the side. That was great. Last week she took a huge hop forward. So she's kind of honing in on her landings now, and that was a fantastic vault for her.
9-8-5 for Marcia Newby, the top score for Georgia on the vault so far tonight. Here is Gail Mackey.
Gail starts off with a heck mount over the low bar, kip handstand to a blind change, and a huge release move. Her second handstand is all the way up. That's a Higgins turn to a Pike Jaeger. So far, two release moves in her bar routine, both of them very big. Overshoot to the low bar. Now her handstand was a little bit short at the end. Two giants to a double layout. And a stuck landing, and she turned to salute the judges, so it would be interesting to see what they do with that score as far as the landing goes, but otherwise a very nice routine.
Here's another look at that landing, a 9-8-7-5. We talked about how crucial those landings would be when you have two teams with All-Americans such as Georgia and Utah. Courtney Kupetz, the senior.
Courtney's vault is a Yurchenko half on, front pike off, and a very tiny hop at the end, but otherwise a fantastic vault.
A beautiful vault. Will it be perfect? Not quite. Why the 9-9-5 and not the 10, which we actually don't see very much of anymore in college
it's
gymnastics?
It's just that itty-bitty hop at the end and maybe a little bit of a leg separation, but otherwise one of the best vaults we've seen from her.
Daria Bijak.
She starts with a toe shoot Shaposhnikova to the high bar, handstand pirouette, one giant, giant full to a ginger. Second handstand is all the way up, but she actually went over just a little bit and had to pull it back. Did an overshoot to an uphill. Last handstand looks very nice. That's a Higgins turn to a double front and another stuck landing for Utah. So they're doing fantastic on their dismounts tonight.
A A big score for Daria, a 9-9 on the uneven bars. Utah's best score so far tonight. Back over to vault, Tiffany Tolney.
Tiffany was warming up a huge vault, and she did do it here tonight at 1.5. She's one of the only gymnasts in collegiate gymnastics that does that vault. Took a little bit of a hop backwards, but we really haven't seen that vault from her in the past year, so it's good to see her upgrading just a little bit.
Another 9-9, we're starting to see some very big scores from these two teams. How exciting. This is Christina Baskett.
As we said earlier, Christina is a two-time NCAA champion on the uneven bars. She's a giant full to a giant half and a huge reverse hex, immediate pack salto. It's a half pirouette on the low bar to an uphill. Her last handstand is just a little bit short to a double layout dismount and a beautiful landing. So another fantastic routine for Utah.
That routine seemed to go very quickly.
She's a very fast twitch gymnast.
Another big score at 9.925 for Utah. So both teams coming up with big scores towards the end of the rotation. Utah leads the way after one rotation over the Gym Dogs. When we come back, UGA heads to the uneven bars. We are back at Stegman Coliseum, where Utah leads the Georgia Gym Dogs after one rotation, not a position the Gym Dogs are usually in. Here we find Gina Nuccio kicking things off on the uneven bars.
Gina's been great so far for the Gym Dogs. She starts with a giant full to a ginger. A great combination for her. Gets her a little bit more bonus in her routine. Her last handstand is just a little bit short, and she does a full out dismount. And her knees buckled a little bit on the landing, so she had to take that step backwards. But so far, a good routine. And you know, coming in as a freshman, it is a little nerve wracking, but she seems to step up to the plate a lot.
Gina with a 9.825. Here is Annie DeLuzio making her debut here at Stegman tonight.
She'll do Yurchenko full with a big hop backwards, so that's probably going to be the biggest deduction that the judges are going to take on that vault, because otherwise she got great height off the horse and had good execution, just the big hop.
A decent score to start things off for Utah on the vault, a 9.825. Here is Marcia Newby.
Marcia will start her routine with a Shaposhnikova to an overshoot handstand. Marcia, just when she swings bars, you know, her legs are so long that it's absolutely gorgeous. She does a Stalder to a big reverse hecht. Her last handstand's all the way up. She'll do two giants to her new dismount, a double layout, and a step backwards, but otherwise a pretty decent routine.
Take another look here at 9.825, and probably the step is what hurt her. Back over to vault, this is Jamie Dietz-Creek.
Jamie's also going to compete at Yurchenko full. She also takes a hop backwards, so we're not seeing those more controlled landings that we saw them do over on the uneven bars.
A 9.8. For Utah, trying to hang on to that slim lead. Here's Grace Taylor, one of my favorite gymnasts to watch on both the uneven bars and the balance beam.
Grace is a gorgeous gymnast. She does a front Stalder half, overshoot to a handstand, Stalder handstand to a Stalder uphill, and her signature Komenich flip. Her last handstand is all the way up, and two giants to a double layout dismount and a stuck landing. A great bar routine for Grace.
Very nice, and she knows it. Jay Clark likes it as well.
One of my favorite things to watch is the gymnast's faces when they land, if they do stick.
A big score, 9.925. You always had good facial expressions when you had a good routine, I must say. Here is Nina Kim from Utah.
Nina's vault tonight is also a Yurchenko full. And we see with each landing, the hops get a little bit smaller, but they're still there. So it seems like Utah needs to concentrate just a little bit more on trying to stick those landings.
Another 9.8 score. We're seeing a lot of those on vault here for the Utes. The senior from Georgia, another great bar worker, and Tiffany Tolney.
Tiffany is great. You can see each one of her handstands will be all the way up. She does a blind change to a straddled Jaeger, another handstand to an overshoot.
You know, we were here a few weeks ago for the West Virginia meet, and what a difference in caliber between, you know, Utah coming in here and West Virginia. Just the technique alone is outstanding from Georgia and Utah.
And you can also tell that Georgia's competing to their competition this week, too. They know that Utah can outscore them, so they're honing in more on the more minor details.
A big score for Tiffany Tolney, a 9-9.
The only deduction right there at the very end, that step.
Here is Christina Baskett, who had a great bar routine a few minutes ago.
And she has a Yurchenko full as well, and still the landing, the little hop backwards. So the judges are really coming down on the gymnast.
A 9.85. Courtney Coupette from Georgia will round out the second rotation. She's coming off a 9.95 on her vault.
Here she'll do a toe shoot Shaposhnikova to an overshoot handstand to an uphill. Second handstand all the way up. Hop full to a big reverse hecht. Against West Virginia, Courtney did score a 9.975. She only has her dismount left. It's going to be a big double layout. And another fantastic bar routine from Courtney.
Once again, both teams finishing strong on their rotations. And another huge score, a 9.975. This ought to be a very interesting evening. And it's extremely close. The Gym Dogs reclaim the lead. When we come back, we'll talk with UGA head coach Suzanne Yocklin. Stay with us.